In this presentation, we will consider some important questions related to pointers. So let's get started. Here is the first question. Consider the following two statements. We have these two statements written over here. In the first statement, we can see it is written int star p equals to ampersand of I. And in the second statement, it is written p equals to ampersand of I. First statement is the declaration and second is simple assignment statement. Here in the first statement, we are simply declaring this pointer and we are also trying to assign the address of variable I to this pointer. In the second statement, it is just a simple assignment statement. We are not declaring the pointer here. Why isn't in second statement P is preceded by star symbol? In order to answer this question, I would encourage you to pause the video for a while and try to answer this on your own. And then after that, we will move on to the solution. I hope you're done. Okay, let's move on to the solution. In C, star symbol has different meanings depending on the context in which it's used. In C programming language, star symbol has different meanings that depends on the context. At the time of declaration, star symbol is not acting as an indirection operator. When you're declaring a pointer, here star symbol is not acting as an indirection operator or a value of operator. Star symbol in the first statement tells the compiler that p is a pointer to an integer. Here the star symbol is indicating that p is a pointer to an integer. Here it is not acting as an indirection operator. As I told you, star symbol has different meanings depending on the context in which it's used. Here star symbol has different meaning. Star symbol here indicates the compiler that this is a pointer and not a normal variable. And this pointer simply points to an integer variable, right? But if we write star p equals to ampersand of I, then it is wrong. Because here star symbol indicates the indirection operator and we cannot assign the address to some integer variable. If we put a star symbol in front of the statement, it means that we are trying to access the location pointed by this pointer and we are trying to replace that variable content with the address of the variable I. But how is it possible? Pointers can hold the addresses while variables can hold the values. We cannot store the address of some variable to another variable, which is not a pointer. Therefore, if you write the statement, then here the star symbol indicates the indirection operator and we cannot assign the address of some variable to some other integer variable, right? Therefore, in the second statement, there is no need of star symbol in front of P. It simply means we are assigning the address to a pointer. When we write this statement p equals to ampersand of I, we are simply trying to put the address of variable I inside this pointer. If we write a star in front of it, it means that we are trying to access the location pointed by the pointer and we are trying to put the address of variable I to that particular location, which is not possible. Therefore, there is no need to put star over here. Okay, let's move on to our second question. What is the output of the following program? Here is the program and your task is to identify the output of this program. I would encourage you to pause the video and try to answer this question on your own. I hope you're done. Okay, let's see what is the output of this program. Here in this main function, we have these three statements written over here. In the first statement, we can see it's a declaration of a variable I. It's an integer variable which contains value 10. But this variable is not a normal variable, it's a constant variable. If we simply put this const keyword in front of this variable, it means that we cannot change the content of this variable throughout the program. Okay? Now, after this statement, we are calling this function 1 and we are passing the address of this variable I to it. And here in this function, we are receiving the address of this variable I using this pointer p. Please note here that the data type we have to mention over here is the data type of this variable I, because this pointer will store the address of this variable I. Therefore, the data type must match, right? Inside this function, we can see we have a statement star p equals to 0. It means here we are using the star, which means the indirection operator. Here the context of the star is it is acting like an indirection operator, right? Writing star p means we are trying to access the location pointed by this pointer p. P contains the address of variable I, right? Therefore, with the help of this indirection operator, we are trying to access the variable I content. And we are trying to replace that content with value 0. Variable I previously contains value 10. With the help of this statement, we are trying to update that value to 0. But as we can see, it is not possible because this variable is a constant variable. We cannot change the content of this variable throughout the program. Therefore, this program will produce an error message. That is assignment of read-only location star P. So the output is error. Okay. Now let's move on to the third question. How to print the address of a variable? It's a simple question, but it is an important question for us to understand. How to print the address of a variable? Use percentile p as a format specifier in printf function to print the address of a variable. By using this format specifier, we can print the address of a variable in hexadecimal format. For example, if we have this program which contains a main function, and inside this main function we have these four statements written. In the first statement, we have this variable I which contains the value 10, and then we have a pointer p which simply points to this variable I. And with the help of this pointer, we will print the address of this variable I on the screen by using this printf function. Here, by simply writing a format specifier as percentile p, we can print the address of this variable I on the screen. So the output of this program is, the address of variable I is 0x7ffd5p9a987c. This is the address in hexadecimal format of this variable I. It can be different, of course. In my machine, when I run this program, it gives me this address. Let's move on to the next question. If I is a variable and P points to I, which of the following expressions are aliases of I? Is it A star P? Is it B star ampersand P? Is it C ampersand P? Is it D star I? Or is it E star ampersand I? There can be more than one answers for this question. I would again encourage you to pause the video for a while and try to answer this question on your own. I hope you're done. Let's move on to the solution now. Options A and E are the aliases of variable I. Option A, that is star P, and option E, that is star ampersand I, are the aliases of variable I. That means they are giving the same value as the variable I will give. Okay? Let's see how. With the help of this example, we will try to answer this question. Let's say we have a variable I which contains value 10, and we have a pointer P which simply points to this variable I. Pictorially, they can be represented like this. Variable I contains value 10 and the address of this variable is 1000. Variable P contains the address of the variable I in order to point this variable. Therefore, it contains the address 1000 and the address of this pointer is 2000. According to option A, it is written star P. What does it mean? Star P means star 1000, right? If we simply write P, then it means we are trying to access the content of P, which is 1000. So we replace this P by 1000 and then we apply the dereference operator. Star 1000 means go to this location 1000 and access the content stored in that location, which is 10. Therefore, star P is equals to 10, which is equals to I, right? Therefore, we can say that star P is an alias of I. Let's see option B now, star ampersand P. We can also write this star ampersand P as star, these round brackets, and then ampersand P. Obviously, ampersand P will be performed first, and then we will perform the indirection. If you write ampersand P, it means that we are trying to access the address of P, which is 2000. And star 2000 means we are trying to access the content stored in this location, which is 1000. We can clearly see that star ampersand P is not equals to I. Therefore, this option is not a correct option. Let's see option C, ampersand P. Ampersand P means we are trying to access the address of P, which is 2000, which is definitely not equals to I. Therefore, option C is also not a correct option. Let's see option D. Star I means star 10. If we write simply I, then we are trying to access the content stored in I, which is 10. And star 10 doesn't make sense at all, because 10 is not an address. Indirection operator is used to access the content stored in a particular address. But here, it is not an address. Therefore, this statement doesn't make sense at all. Hence, star I is again not equals to I. Hence, option D is not a correct option. Let's see option E. Star ampersand I. Again, we first have to perform this operation, ampersand I. Ampersand I means we are trying to access the address of I, which is 1000. So we can replace this by 1000. And then with the help of this star operator, we can access the content stored in this location 1000, which is 10. Therefore, star 1000 is equals to 10. Hence, star ampersand I is equals to 10, which is equals to I, right? Hence, options A and E are the aliases of variable I, right? Okay, friends, this is it for now. Thank you for watching this presentation.